respected dignitaries, families, IEDC members, seniors and my dear colleagues. Good afternoon to one and all. Myself, Angel Rose CHAKKIATH, I am from S2BM. Today, I am here before you to express my ideas and views or to share my experience on a small topic. When I came to know that IEDC is conducting an open mic competition for the technical paper presentation and life experience sharing, I was really surprised. At the moment itself, the topic came to my mind is not a small one, it's threat. Because I was also affected by that threat. And I think you people might have heard about it, or majority of you had come in person, isn't it? Yes. So, Kerala threat of 2018 was the continuous impact of extreme rainfall and reservoir storage. As heavy rain continues to last this week, the dam near to Sahrdaya, that is Merigalgut dam, has begun overflowing, making the people who live nearby much safer. It happened on August 15, 2018, the same day of independence. And it was the most memorable day in my life I have ever experienced. Because when I wake up for the preparation of morning mass, we were hearing a roaring sound from outside. At that time, when we look outside, we noticed that our house was fully surrounded with water. And the case is that my house is just in front of Chakkiath River. And in my village, the first house affected by this flood was mine. So that so many tourists and travelers were visiting my house. So in the beginning, we were very much happy. But after 1 or 2 hours, these people were unable to return back due to the increased level of water. I can surely say that Kerala flood of August 2018 was not created by any god or any supernatural powers. It was the only mistake done by the government by opening 35 dams without any information or news through any social media. So that much higher was the water level. And we didn't expect this much of water so early. And on 15th evening, we moved to our cousin's house. And at that night, that house was also affected. And 16th morning, we moved to the camp. And after some time, camp was also surrounded with water. So you can imagine our situation. Our situation was that much severe. And we called the rescue many times, but there was no response. And the boat dedicates to us due to the higher water current level. And from 16th August to 21st August was the worst phase in my life, because we 130 people in that camp was very much short of food and water. No food, no water for any purpose, including kitchen and washroom. And in my older days, my parents and grandparents used to say that you children are not giving any value to food and water. So many children are living in our country, living with starvation. And at that time, we didn't mind their words. But on those 6 days, we clearly understood the value of even little amount of water. And we came to know that money has no value of its own in our life. Because everybody in that camp has money with them, but nothing to do with that. That much severe our condition was. And after the flood was the worst days, that is cleaning the house. We took almost 10 days to clean our house and everything, including laptop, fridge, washing machine, mobile, tabs, everything has gone. And my house was 20 years old, so you can imagine how much damage will happen. So this flood has contributed that much damage to my family. Not only to my family, but to my entire village. And it's the case that Kerala received abnormally high rainfall from 1st of 2018 to 19th August 2018. And as per the IEDC data, it received 2,346.6 mm of rainfall instead of having 1,000 and something. And this only resulted in the severe flooding in 13 out of 14 districts in our state. And a state official had told AFP that 370 people were dying and 33,000 people were rescued from this flood. The solution to be adopted for these type of disasters is providing better awareness to the society and giving relevant information through social media. So, not only that, the government of Kerala should provide better trainings we can change a lot in our actions. Extending our hands to people in need of help, we can change not only their lives but also ours. So be the change of tomorrow.